company that has the capacity of manufacturing weapons should not be held in the hands of anybody. I mean, considering the fact that we tend to focus more on our diversity here, what we tied it be in the hands of an Ibira or an Igbo man or a Hausa? It should be a property of the Nigerian, of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, sir. So, and I will tell you that the idea of privatization tends to create a lot of green-eyed monsters. The idea that somebody can own such a magnificent structure creates such uncontrollable greed. And I will speak about this. Sometime last year, it got to my findings that a particular company was registered to acquire Ajaokuta. It's called Ajaokuta Cookie Nigeria Limited. I have before me the papers that prove that this company was authorized, the registration of this company was authorized by the governor of Kogi State, Alhaji Yahaya Bello, in partnership with Global Infrastructure Nigeria Limited, the same people. Now they have gotten it away into their hands. And the next target was to acquire Ajaokuta at all costs. So they buy the place. And going by the certified true copy of the form CAC7, a company that is supposed to carry the front and the interest of the people of Kogi State, if, well, we know it's a federal asset, but supposing the Federal Republic of Nigeria has given Kogi State the mandate to proceed with ownership, resuscitation, and operations of Ajaokuta, you will all assume that Kogi State should be a major shareholder, isn't it? But what I have here, the two directors of this company, one, Onoche Ikechukwu, who's from Benue State, and Anchaba Emmanuel from the eastern part of Nigeria. And both of them, it will interest you, are affiliates, staff of Global Infrastructure Nigeria Limited. Both of them share no other director influence. This is a shell company, sir. If it had succeeded, do you mind looking at this? If it had gone through, we would have, on the face of it, assumed that Ajaokuta was then already in possession of Kogi State, probably working for the good people of Kogi State and Nigeria, when in reality, it's just a company that is owned by two people who are promoting vested interests. So we wrote a petition. On the 3rd of July, we wrote a petition to the Registrar General of CAC. And he was very shocked. I wouldn't bore you with the happenings there, but he was very shocked. And he ordered a committee. To the best of his knowledge, the files before him did not contain that the company was registered. He knew where it was registered already months before that.